Alright, so for my project, I gathered data on the population of every country in the world. And I compared annual growth rates and pretty much just did my data project on growth rates. And then I used the growth rates to pretty much predict the future population of every country. And then I used that to predict the future of the world population. So as you can see here, what I just told you. And then I split it up into two scenarios over a long period of time, which was 1950 to 2016. And then I did 2010 to 2016. And then, like I said before, I can compare the two. And I'll show you how that came up later. So first scenario, 1950 to 2016. And this was a long term. So the mean was 1.82%. And that was the average growth rate of each country when I added up the long term. And then the median was 1.92%. So there were six outliers: Montserrat, Kuwait, St. Martin, which is an island in the Caribbean, Western Sahara, Qatar, United Arab Emirates. And the United Arab Emirates was my interesting country for the long term, so I'll tell you why it was an outlier later. And the data ranged from -1.5% was Montserrat to United Arab Emirates, which was 7.7%. So this was my histogram. As you can see, the growth rates on the bottom and the number of countries on the left, and you can see it's left skewed. What is supposed to be on there?
What do you want me to do?
Did you go to keep going until you see the? And it's still a little more. There it is. So the United Arab Emirates was my interesting country for the long term. And, it was the biggest one, and so it's pretty much like a cultural center, almost like Dubai. So it had a high migration rate and a diverse population, with only 13% being actually born there.
Do you want me to go back?
Yeah.
Okay.
So my second scenario was 2010 to 2016. This is more recent. So like the difference would be like over 66 years, it's hard to tell if a country goes down or up in between because there's so many numbers. So in this, it's only 6 years. So say you have two numbers that are negatives and four that are positive. That's already 33% that are negative. So it's obviously going to be more precise and more accurate over a short period of time. So my calculations for the short term was, the mean was 1.27%, obviously the average of that. The median was 1.2, and then there was also six outliers in the short term, and there was Syria, Kuwait, Lebanon, Caribbean, Netherlands, Oman, and Nui. And the data ranged from -2.5 to 12.3, so a lot more spread out than before. And then the standard deviation was 1.60%. Alright, so the distribution, I thought this was pretty cool because it's pretty much symmetrical. So you can see the growth rates on the bottom, number of countries on the side. You can see, like I said, symmetrical, but there's a few outliers out here. And that was where my last line came. So my interesting country for the short term was the USA, obviously, because that's where we live. It was 0.58%, which I thought was very low for us, because I thought migration to the US would make it be a lot higher. So it's low because the levels of migration is actually decreasing to the US, and population aging and fertility rates are declining. Alright, so comparison between long and short. Yeah, they're not on the same scale, but you can tell the shorter term is more spread out. And that's because it's more precise than the long term, because long term there's too many numbers to actually get precise to see if it goes up and down. And I did a time series line graph. The blue is the long term, and the orange is the short term.